From his throne on Mount Olympus, mighty Zeus ruled over God and man alike, maintaining order and justice in the universe. His thunderbolt of vengeance, the most feared weapon on Earth and in the heavens.
In Greek mythology, Zeus was the king of the gods, ruler of Mount Olympus, the god of sky and weather, law, order, and fate. He was depicted as a regal man, mature, with sturdy figure and dark beard. His symbols were a lightning bolt, royal scepter, oak tree, and eagle. Zeus was the son of Cronus and Rhea. He was the youngest of five siblings, Hestia, Demeter, Hera, Hades, and Poseidon. The Titan Cronus swallowed his children as soon as they were born, since he had learned from a prophecy that he was destined to be overcome by his own child. But when Zeus was born, his mother Rhea devised a plan to save him. Rhea gave birth to Zeus, handing Cronus a rock wrapped in cloth, which he promptly swallowed. When Zeus had grown into a young man, he returned to his father's domain, forcing Cronus to regurgitate the five children he had previously swallowed. Zeus led the revolt against his father and the Titans, whom he defeated and banished to the shadowy underworld region known as Tartarus. Once Zeus had control, he and his brothers divided the universe between them, Zeus gaining the heavens, Poseidon the sea, and Hades the underworld. Zeus was married to his sister Hera. Zeus was subject to pleasure, pain, grief, and anger, but he was most susceptible to the power of love, which often got the objects of his desire in a lot of trouble with his wife Hera. According to legend, Metis was the first love of Zeus. At first she tried in vain to escape his advances, but in the end succumbed to his endeavor, becoming pregnant. Gaia had prophesied that Metis' first child would be a girl who would equal her father in wisdom and strength. Her next child would be a boy who would depose Zeus. Unwilling to give up the leadership of the god, Zeus ate Metis. Sometime later, Zeus developed a terrible headache. Hephaestus realized what was happening and split his head open. Suddenly then, Athena leapt forth with a shout. She was full grown and armed as a warrior. Another love of Zeus was Europa. He had abducted the Phoenician princess disguised as a bull, then carried her on his back to the island of Crete where she bore three sons, Minos, Rhadamanthus, and Sarpedon. Zeus became smitten with Io. He consummated his relationship with the maiden by forming a cloud to conceal his affair. Hera noticed a strange dark cloud and went to Earth to investigate. Zeus, in the meantime, had transformed Io into a white cow in order to protect his mistress from Hera's notorious wrath. Upon arriving at the scene, Hera asked about the lovely cow. Zeus was forced to give the white cow to his wife. The goddess told Argus, a monster with many eyes, to guard the cow. Zeus sent his son Hermes to get rid of Argus, and after Hermes conquered the guardian monster, Hera became even more angry and sent a gadfly to sting and pursue Io. She wandered to and fro, trying to escape from the gadfly. Finally, she reached Egypt, where she was at last restored to her original form. Zeus had many temples and festivals in his honor. The temple of Olympian Zeus, known as the Olympion, is a colossal ruined temple in the center of the Greek capital, Athens, that was dedicated to Zeus, king of the Olympian gods. The most famous of his sanctuaries was at Olympia, a magnificent temple of Zeus, which held the gold and ivory statue of the enthroned Zeus, sculpted by Phidias and hailed as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. The Roman counterpart to Zeus was Jupiter. Jupiter, also called Jove, was a supreme god of the Roman pantheon called Dies Pater, Shining Father. He was a god of light and sky and protector of the state and its laws. He was the son of Saturn and husband to his sister Juno. The Romans worshipped him especially as Jupiter Optimus Maximus, all good, all powerful. The largest temple in Rome was that of Jupiter Optimus Maximus on the Capitoline Hill. Here he was worshipped alongside Juno and Minerva, forming the Capitoline Triad. Temples to Jupiter Optimus Maximus, or the Capitoline Triad as a whole, were commonly built by the Romans at the center of new Roman cities. An example of this is the Temple of Jupiter in Pompeii. In the modern era, the myths of Zeus are still studied. The story of Zeus is represented in art and music today.
From the global celebration of the Olympic Games to the awe-inducing temples and monuments erected in his honor, Zeus's legend remains as strong as the god himself.